nerve supply of the pharynx. It has the motor supply and the sensory supply. First of all, the motor supply. All the muscles of the pharynx, constrictor as well as the longitudinal, are supplied by the cranial root of the SSC nerve. That is the 11th cranial nerve. Here the 11th cranial nerve directly not supply. It is through pharyngeal branches of the vagus nerve. On the middle constrictor, there is a formation of the pharyngeal plexus. This pharyngeal plexus, it rests on the middle constrictor. It is formed by the three structures. It is the glossopharyngeal nerve branches, it is the vagus nerve branches, and it is the sympathetic chain, sympathetic branches of the superior cervical sympathetic ganglion. These three branches form the pharyngeal plexus, and through this plexus, this motor supply, all the muscles are supplied, and the best branches are coming from the cranial root of the SSC nerve, and it is distributed through the pharyngeal branch of the vagus nerve to this pharyngeal plexus, except stylopharynges. All the muscles except this longitudinal muscles, stylopharyngeus, it is supplied by the cranial ninth, that is the glossopharyngeal nerve. It is the glossopharyngeal nerve separately supply this only stylopharyngeus muscles, and the thyropharyngeus, that is the part of the inferior constrictor, it is the thyropharyngeus and the picopharyngeus. They have the additional nerve supply. They are also supplied by the thyropharyngeus, is supplied by the external laryngeal nerve. This external laryngeal nerve, which is the division of the superior laryngeal nerve, branch of the vagus nerve. This external laryngeal nerve supplies the cricothyroid muscles and also supplies the thyropharyngeus part of the inferior constrictor. And this cricopharyngeus, the lower part of the inferior constrictor, also supplied by this recurrent laryngeal nerve, another branch of the vagus nerve. So, this thyropharyngeus and the cricopharyngeus have additional nerve supply in spite of this. Now the sensory supply, the nasopharynx, it is supplied by the branches of the maxillary nerve through the pterygopalatine ganglion. It is the pharyngeal branches, and these pharyngeal branches comes out from the pterygopalatine ganglion, held by this maxillary nerve, and supplies the mucosa of the nasopharynx. The oropharynx, it is supplied by the branches of the glossopharyngeal nerve. Glossopharyngeal nerve, mixed nerve. Motor only supplies stylopharyngeus. More prominent is the sensory, and it supplies the mucosa of the oropharynx. While the laryngopharynx, its mucosa, its sensory supply is by the internal laryngeal nerve. Internal laryngeal nerve. So it is the motor supply and it is the sensory supply of the pharynx. Now the arterial supply, venous supply and the lymphatic drainage of the pharynx. The arterial supply, the pharynx is supplied by the ascending pharyngeal artery, branches of the ascending pharyngeal artery. It is a branch of the external carotid artery. It is supplied by the branches of the ascending palatine artery and the tonsillar artery. Both are branches of the facial artery. And the facial artery is a branch of the external carotid artery. It is also supplied by the pharyngeal branches and the greater palatine branches of the maxillary artery. That are the branches of the third part of the maxillary artery, it is the pharyngeal and the greater palatine branches that supply the pharynx. And it is also supplied by the branches of the lingual artery. This lingual artery, it is a branch of the external carotid artery. So these are the arteries that supply the pharynx. Now the venous genus, it forms the pharyngeal plexus of the veins, like the pharyngeal plexus of the nerve. And these pharyngeal plexus, they are the tributaries of this internal jugular vein, drains into the internal jugular vein. Now the lymphatic drainage, the pharynx directly or indirectly supply drain into the deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. It is the upper and the lower deep cervical. Upper one, that is the jugulodigastric, while the lower one, it is the jugulohumeral. So the pharynx either drains into the retropharyngeal group of the lymph nodes, and it drains into the deep cervical group of the lymph nodes, or the pharynx directly drains into the deep cervical group of the lymph nodes. So it is about the pharynx. The nasopharynx that allow the passage of only air, while the oropharynx that allow the passage of the food as well as the air, while the laryngopharynx that allow the passage of both food and the air. This pharynx is a big topic, and the important points in the pharynx that may be asked in the examinations, it is the nasopharynx. The important features of the nasopharynx. Draw the diagram and the label the nasopharynx, or what is the word air stream. Short note on the word air stream. Then it is the laryngeal inlet. The important structures, laryngeal inlet, then piriform fossa, and of course it is a tonsil. Tonsil is a separate class. Tonsil and the tonsillar fossa will discuss in the separate class. Then it is the motor surface, nerve supply of the pharynx. Nerve supply of the pharynx, both motor and the sensory. It is important for the wire point of view. All the muscles are supplied by except one, which muscles and what are their nerve supply. Then what is the oropharyngeal isthmus, and what is the pharyngeal isthmus. Oropharyngeal isthmus, what is the oropharyngeal isthmus and its boundary, and what is the pharyngeal isthmus. So these are the short topics. From this big topic, the questions are frequently asked in the examination, and we will discuss this topic in the practical also. I will send the video of this practical as soon as possible on my channel. Thank you very much.